came across a phenomenal series called from Bloomberg called Game Changers.
Yes, sir.
People, you know, you don't have to have cable anymore.
That's right.
You have the internet and Netflix and you're good.
That's it.
You can go and stream television today.
Yes,
you know why people pay $300 for cable? I don't get it. But in this series, Bloomberg presents a series called Game Changers. And it chronicles people's lives who have revolutionized the industry that they are a part of. It chronicles Jay-Z and how he revolutionized the music industry as it pertains to hip-hop.
Yes, sir.
It goes on and it talks about the man who started Costco and also the one who started Whole Foods. And one of my favorite was Steve Jobs.
Yes, sir.
How he revolutionized not only the cell phone industry, but the music industry.
Yes, sir.
He virtually made the CD player irrelevant.
That's right.
You know, we went from 8 tracks to cassette tapes,
right,
to CDs, and now MP3s. And so he revolutionized because now you don't have to go to the store and buy music. You can go to Apple Music or Pandora or Spotify and you can download it and stream it through your device. He revolutionized the music industry.
That's right.
And then Lord knows he revolutionized the phone industry.
Yes.
I can remember as a little boy growing up, we had a car phone, but not we. My parents had a car phone and it was in a bag.
That's right.
And listen, it was 75 cents a minute.
That's right.
And so they would never keep the phone plugged in. You only took it out when you had to use it. That was one of the sometimes my daddy almost cussed me out because I didn't know that, and I had the phone and I was just making calls, calling people, and I didn't realize it was 75 cents a minute. And so when you fuss at your parents because they don't keep their cell phones on, it's because they grew up in the era where you only turned it on when you needed it.
All right.
That's
my minute.
Yes. Yes. Right? And if you still count minutes, then you in bad shape because most plans now have unlimited talking and texting. He completely revolutionized the phone industry. And you know, he had said, well, BlackBerry had said nobody will be using touch screens. And now, everywhere you turn, there are touch screens.
Yes.
And there are a few people who still use flip phones.
Yeah.
Just a few. You have a flip phone tonight, just bow your head. We can pray for you. Lord, let them upgrade and update. In Jesus' name. But these are people in the Bloomberg report who changed the industry they were in.
Yes, sir.
And as I thought about that, and I read the text that is in our hearing tonight, not only were the people on Netflix Bloomberg special game changers, but there are game changers in Scripture.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yep. And Samson tonight is one of those game changers.
Yes, sir.
The Bible says in verse 1, again the Israelites did evil in the eyes of the Lord. That word again lets us know that this is not the first time. Because I have a sneaky suspicion that the Israelites had to be Black Baptists. Because their mode of operation looks just like our mode of operation. We would be doing good for a little while, and then we would get complacent. We would start distancing ourselves from God. We would get in trouble. We would cry out to God. God would raise up in the book of Judges a judge to deliver his people. They would will do good for a little while. Then they will go back to business as usual. They will distance themselves from God. They will get in trouble. They will cry out to God. God will raise up a judge. They will deliver them from their trouble. The Israelites will do good for a little while. Then they'll go back to business as usual. Are you hearing me? They will distance themselves from God. They will get in trouble. They will cry out to God. God will raise up a judge to deliver them out of their predicament. And they will do good for a little while. Sounds just like you and I. If you be honest tonight, we do good for a little while. Then we get complacent. And we figure we can make it without God now. And then we get in trouble. We cry out to God. God, deliver us from our dilemma. We do good for a good 6 weeks. And then it's back to business as usual. Are you with me? Now listen, don't play like that ain't you. Because there have been times in your life that God has blessed you. You remember that time when you was walking and you prayed for a car? And you said that, Lord, if you bless me with a car, I promise I'm going to go to church. And you did that for the first 2 months. And then after the first 2 months, you started complaining because they ain't got no parking lot. And you don't want people parking close to your car. And then you stopped coming to church until you couldn't pay the car note. And then you started praying and crying out to God to help you pay your car note. God blessed you, and you did good for it. It is the cycle that we all go through. Because how many of you know that sometimes we don't look for God and we don't seek after God until we in trouble? And when we get in trouble, that's when we start getting serious about God. Are you hearing me? Some of y'all don't pay attention in church while the preacher preaches. You're texting and you're on Instagram and you're Snapchatting. But when somebody bullying you or your boyfriend and broke your heart or your girlfriend and got another girlfriend, now you're all upset and now you're coming to church telling my Lord, I need a word from you to help me make it this year. All of us can get caught up in that cycle if we are not careful. And so it was a very dark time in the history of Israel because the Bible says, again, they did evil in the eyes of the Lord. It is something about getting complacent that becomes the source of evil. And I believe that what we're looking at in our country and in our world today is the result of us getting complacent. Are you hearing me? We have lived now better than we ever had. We are more educated now, more than we've ever been. We have more opportunities now. And I think we thought we had arrived. And some way, somehow, people of color have left God and figured out since you done got the promotion and since you can go and be a part of the country club, you don't need God now until God raises up a 45 and puts him in the White House. And now we have an all kind of gehenna. And now we're crying out to God, telling out, God, help people who have never voted for us. You settle for less than God's purpose for you. Are you hearing me? When you get complacent, what you are saying is, God, I don't want your best. Because I'm of the opinion tonight, as good as God has been, we have not seen him at his best. As much as God has blessed us, there is more that he is going to bless us with. There is so much more that God wants to pour into our lives, but we have got complacent.
Yeah.
Are you hearing me? Look at your neighbor and say, don't get complacent. And you get a good grade, you can't figure you're going to get the A the rest of the time. If that you get an A the first test, that means you got to grind even harder so you can get an A on the second test. And you got to hustle even a little harder if you want to make an A on the third test. Don't get complacent. And I'm not talking about just this. positive things, but there can be a point in a time we get complacent with God.
Yes.
And the truth of the matter is, sometimes we don't pray until we're in trouble. Sometimes we don't cry out to God till our backs are up against the wall. And so if your back is up against the wall tonight, and the walls are caving in, and the ceiling is falling down, somebody ought to bless God tonight, because that's God's way of getting your attention, so you can put down the telephone, put down the mobile phone, and pick up the textbook and start texting and talking to God. The Israelites did evil in the eyes of the Lord. So the Lord put them in the hands of the Philistines. I'm sorry, that was a typo. Because God was going to get their attention. Isn't it amazing how trouble gets our attention? Anybody want to bear witness in here tonight? That trouble will get your attention. And it was a very dark time in the history of this nation.
Yes, sir.
They are under the oppression of the Philistines.
Yes, sir.
Look at your neighbor and say oppression.
Oppression.
Watch what happens, because one of the things you will see throughout the life of Israel is that when they did get in trouble, at least they had enough sense to pray.
Yes.
And even when it didn't look like God was doing anything, God was working.
Yes,
sir. Because in our text tonight, the angel of the Lord, when you read that, that is Jesus before he was born in Bethlehem. You call that a Christophany. Look at your neighbor and say a Christophany. It is when Jesus appears in the Bible before he was born in Bethlehem. Because you do know that he existed before he was born in Bethlehem. Because John says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So Jesus was with God in the beginning. Ask me why. Because he was God. So when God stepped out on the balcony of glory and said, let there be, that was Jesus talking. So the angel of the Lord comes and appears to this woman, listen to this, who could not get pregnant. Oh, Lord. Listen. She couldn't get pregnant. Don't tell nobody I told y'all this in church, but she tried. Look at your neighbor and say, she did try. You understand what I'm saying? Her and her husband, Manoah, they did kick it to a little Kendrick Lamar. You understand what I'm saying? Right there. At the very time you have forgotten about God, I'm so glad.